Good day to all of you. Now today we will be going to discuss on the topic, that is plus system. So firstly we will see the types of clutches which is used in tractor as well as in any automobile vehicle. According to method of transmitting the torque, the clutches are to be classified in following types. Number first, that is a positive clutch, it is also called as dog clutch. Second one is the friction clutch. Friction clutch is again classified in 2-3 type, that is cone clutch. Number first, second is single plate clutch, third one is a multi plate clutch, and fourth one is a diaphragm clutch. Again, hydraulic clutch is classified in two types, that is fluid coupling and hydraulic torque converter. So we will see the details of one by one. Firstly, we will see the application of clutches in automobile. Number first, single plate clutch is almost all motor vehicles where manual transmission is take place. That means there where manual transmission is necessary, that time single plate clutch is used. Second one, cone clutch was used in some automobile in partially, but now is restricting to racing, rally cars and power boats. Third one is the centrifugal clutch is used on petrol powered lawnmower. That means movers have used a centrifugal type of clutch. As the lawnmower is revved at a higher speed, the centrifugal force spreads the clutch sway apart so that clutch mechanism is engaged in position. Fourth one, multi-plate clutch are used in extreme car racing and in automobile gearbox system. Next one, frictional clutch, that is single plate clutch. So we'll see the firstly its component, then after its working. See here, I have shown here diagrammatically various components of single plate clutch. This one is the clutch cover in which all the assembly of clutch is to be installed. This one is the flywheel which is taken power from the engine. This one is the clutch plate. See here. This one is the pressure plate. This one is the throwout bearing. And here is the transmission from there. Power is to be transmitted to the differential. So how it will be work? These are the frictional plates which is held between flywheel and pressure plate. This one is the flywheel section and this one is the pressure plate section. In this section the friction plate is to become held. Second, that is springs are arranged circumferentially. That means those springs are to be arranged circumferentially and the sections. Frictional plate is mounted on hub. A pedal is provided to pull the pressure plate against the spring force when it is required to disengage in position. That means engage and disengage positions is to be operated by using the pedal. Next one, here is I have shown the diagram properly in view to understand the working of single plate clutch. This one is the engine shaft which is taken power from engine. This engine shaft is attached to this one is the flywheel. See here, flywheel. Next one is the spigot end. This one is the pressure plate. This one is the clutch plate. Here is springs are provided circumferentially. This one is the paddle which is operated by driver during the engaging and disengaging the engine from gearbox. This one is the fulcrum point. This one is the clutch shaft. This one is the bearings. Okay, these are the various parts as well as components in single plate clutch system. Next one is the multi plate clutch. Firstly, we'll see the components of multi plate clutch. This one is the engine shaft. This one is the disc plate. See here, these are the disc plates 1, 2, 3. This one is the flywheel which is attached to engine shaft. These are the frictional rings which are splined. See here, this. These are the frictional lining. This is the spring and this one is the driven shaft. Okay, drive shaft is engine shaft and driven shaft which is supplying power to the transmission, that means for the gearbox. So multi plate clutch is same as single plate clutch, but there is two or more clutch plates are inserted between the flywheel and pressure plate. The clutch is compact, then single plate clutch for same transmission of torque is used. That is,
The difference between single plate clutch and multi-plate clutch is that single plate consists of pressure plate and clutch plates are only single. But in case of multi-plate clutch, there are several types of plates are to be used.
See here, here is shown diagrammatically how the power transmission from engine to the gearbox is done. This one is the driving shaft, this one is the flywheel which is attached to driving shaft. These are the frictional linings. This one is the pressure plate. This is the spring which is mounted circumferentially. This one is the bearing. This is the fulcrum point on which pedal link is attached. This one is the clutch pedal. These are the splines which is provided on shaft. This one is the driven shaft. So next one is the disc clutches. This type of clutch consists of two flanges. One flange is rigidly to the driving shaft and other flange fit to the driven shaft. That means single flange, two flanges are to be provided. One flange attached to driving shaft, that means for the flywheel, and another one for the driven shaft. Single flange clutches are used in automobiles. That means most of the tractors have provided single disc clutch. When large torque transmission is required, the multi-disc clutch are used. Multi-disc clutch has more number of contact surface, that means disc, on the driving and driven shaft. See here, this is the diagram of disc clutch on which I have shown the various components. Number first, frictional disc clutch. This one is the pressure plate, this one is the flywheel. This one is the diaphragm spring, this one is the housing in which all the assembly of disc clutch is to be housed. These are the release bearing and this one is the release lever. Thank you.